I'll be talking about issues that happen with femtosecond capsulotomy, and one of the common situations where this happens is when you have a small pupil. So something that usually works well is by cheating the machine a little bit, and we manually adjust the diameter of the pupil that the machine has detected, and we increase it manually. And that usually works well. So we usually get an adequate size rexus, which is well within the pupil diameter on most instances. But sometimes this can go wrong, such as in this case, where once we took up the patient for surgery, we noticed that there was some pigment dispersion, which is why we stained this particular patient. And when you look at this case, it's quite evident that a part of the capsulotomy by the femtosecond laser has been done over the iris. So the energy has been delivered onto the iris, and quite evidently, there is an area of uncut capsulotomy. So in these situations, this can be quite tricky because you have that uncut area, and it's possible that this can go peripherally. So it's important to be extremely gentle, extremely careful, and do a manual capsular excis here in this area. If we had micro forceps, that could have probably been made things a little easier. But with the regular capsular excis forceps, doing it very slowly and gently, we were able to satisfactorily complete the manual capsular excis here. And following that, we were able to take the capsule out. And this particular case was uneventful after that. Another situation where you can have these issues with capsulotomy is when you have white mature cataract. So we do usually increase the energy settings and increase the depth of the capsulotomy as well in white mature cataracts, because you can possibly have tags left behind, because there is some milky cortex that is released at the time of capsulotomy, and it's quite common to have some incomplete capsule tags left behind in white mature cataract. So that's why it's important to stain white mature cataract cases even in femtocapsulotomy, because you want to be a little careful. And sometimes you have what looks like a complete rexus, but if you look carefully here, there is that uncut area of about 2 crocas. And if we were not careful, this could have gone peripherally. But sometimes in cases like this, where we have about a 6 clock hours of uncut capsulotomy, and we did manage to get a manual capsular rexus, but as soon as we went in and we did the nuclear segmentation, we realized that the anterior capsule has gone posteriorly, and there is a posterior capsular tear, which is quite large, with drop of the contents. So it's important to be very careful with these first few steps in femtosecond laser, as we saw in these two cases. And it's important to remove the anterior capsule as if we were doing a manual capsular excis, so that in case there are any incomplete tags, we end up getting still a round circular complete rexus. And another initial step that's important to be careful with is the hydrodissection. So you have these air bubbles that are trapped posteriorly. So it's best to do a gentle rock and roll maneuver, bring up these posteriorly trapped air bubbles. And once you've done that, to do a gentle hydrodissection. Important to be a little more gentle in these cases as compared to routine phacoemulsification. And as in routine cases, it's important to ensure nuclear rotation in these cases as well. So thank you so much. Thank you for the opportunity.
Yeah, that were wonderful take-home points you have shown in the challenges with a femtocataract platform beautifully.